right. Anyways, guys, welcome back to 50 Shades of BS. If you're watching, you can totally tell the idiot's not here today. We have our manager filling in for him since homeboy wanted to fucking do a sex change or whatever he had to do at the hospital. All I know, he got something up his butt, according to his Instagram story or Snapchat. But we have Jenny here today to guest host, and we have so much shit to talk about since we were just in Disneyland. We were doing a whole bunch of hood rat shit over there.
With our Mickey ears on.
Yeah. Even though we were horrible at sneaking in alcohol.
I did it one day.
Yeah, but we didn't even drink the fucking... thing.
We did it the wrong day because we can actually drink at California Adventure.
I know. We fucked up. Honestly, I did get fucked up in California Adventures. That's why I went home and slept.
Yeah, you passed out. I couldn't get a hold of you. And then finally somebody texted me. They're like, little T sleeping. I'm like...
Okay. My little sister, she's like, yeah, everyone was calling you. Arnold was looking for me and everything. Well, dude, your fucking brother-in-law, future brother-in-law, whatever, Hector. That fool was drinking. I was shocked because the night before, he didn't want to drink. First of all, Jenny's family adopted me. I feel well loved. Sally took care of me. She said I was amazing. If she was younger, she would hang out with me.
To this day, she still talks about you.
See, that's what I'm talking about. And then I brought out the drinking side of Hector because I heard he doesn't really talk. I have that in me.
And you scared my sister and my cousin away with the Jaeger bombs. Oh, yeah.
It was Vanessa and Lizzie. Uh-huh. Okay. Yeah, I like how she introduced herself because you acted like I knew everyone already when I walked
in. She was in the shower when you first came the first night. Or when you showed up, she was in the shower.
Yeah, but I met Lizzie and Hector at your house. Yeah. But
it was
just whatever, hi bye bullshit. But yeah, now they're my friends. They added me on Instagram.
Invited to the pizza party.
Yeah, when your mom's kitchen's ready, I'm gonna go make vegan pizza, guys. So if anybody wants to join me, and it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be a strawberry shaped pizza. Because they're from the hood. Oh yeah, Izzy, make sure you put Jenny from the block under her.
No, it's from the hood.
Oh yeah, Jenny from the hood. Jenny from the block.
Youngest son baptized me with that name.
Jenny from the block?
Jenny from the hood.
Jenny from the hook.
Hood.
Oh
my god.
I'm sorry guys, I'm a little sick and I got 24 hours to get better before I leave to Mexico.
Tino got COVID while we're in Disneyland.
I did not get COVID. I tested negative. I got a fucking cold and I have a wedding to go to.
Why am I sitting in here with you? There's no windows.
I know, right? I should turn on the exhaust. No, you're good, Ed. I just have allergies. I fucking sound like Selena now.
Allergies.
Yeah, that's when I got a haircut yesterday. Gabe's like, don't tell me you walked in here with that fucking COVID bullshit. Bro, calm down. And I whipped out my fucking negative test results. This shit looks like you
dated like 3 months ago.
Yeah, I know. Fuck. Imagine if I do have COVID and like when I get to Mexico, I have to stay there for 21 days.
I think you do it on purpose.
Just to be on vacation?
Just to stay in Mexico.
Yeah, so if you guys don't see a podcast for 21 days.
And you're going to be stuck by yourself and nobody's going to be there to translate for you.
But I know.
I love how my mom kept trying to talk to you in Spanish.
And I just looked at her.
You just look at her and I'm like, Mom, doesn't speak Spanish. Oh, I forget. Why don't you? And then she don't get all mad at you. Why don't you speak Spanish? Why
I'm going to teach you. I'm going to fucking teach you to learn. I was like, okay. I was all scared. But yeah, no. But Disneyland was fun. How long? We were there from... Well, I was gone from fucking Thursday pretty much to... Tuesday, Wednesday.
Yeah.
I barely got home.
You were in Reno before that.
Oh, yeah. Wednesday. Yeah. Wednesday, I went to Reno. Thursday, I came home for a little bit. And then I went to
shitty ass.
Yes, we did. That's when 22-year-old came out with us that day.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. We almost got killed. There was a shooting. Oh, dude, we've been through some hood ass shit going downtown. Yeah, 22-year-old came out with us. And then. 22-year-old is way cooler than 23-year-old, by the way.
Just saying.
Yeah. Just saying. I'm going to talk all this shit. If Austin was here, I would have confronted him about the...
But now you're scared of 22-year-old.
Oh, yeah. She'll fucking stab me. She did slap me hanging out for the first time. All because I poked her.
We showed her all the cool spots.
Yeah.
We didn't want to go to Johnny's. We ended up at Johnny's.
Yeah, we took her to the dugout. That's our sacred place.
Yeah.
That's our safe haven for now on.
She's like, I love it here. I want to come every week. Yeah.
I know. She was supposed to come yesterday, but I was dying. We got fucked up. I was.
All
dude, bored. I woke up. And everyone walks in, why is it so hot in here? I was like, let it be. I had the fucking steamers on. My fucking room was a sauna.
Yeah, I remember you that picture.
Yeah. All the fucking, I had the two steamers. I just laid on it. Oh, dude, I'm trying everything I can to get better by tomorrow because I do not want to be fucking.
They're not going to let you on the plane.
Fuck no. Look at Selena looks more sick than me all the time. And you fucking all sniffles, all fucking.
Why do you think I got drunk every night at camping? So I wouldn't have to hear her snore.
I know, she's in fucking out. Allergy fucking hell right there with all the fucking pollen by all the plants.
I just passed out.
Oh, camping was fun. Did you listen to the last story where I talked?
And by the way, none of that even happened.
From my recollection, who knows? I was drunk. It was camping.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys, either way. But yeah, me and Selena be leaving tomorrow. And I'm nervous because I've never been to Mexico.
That's not even Mexico.
I've never been on a plane to Mexico.
It's only a two-hour flight.
It's a three-hour flight.
It's a three.
Yeah. Either way, I upgraded me and Selena's seats so we could drink because Ange told me she wants us showing up drunk already. My phone going off by 22-year-old. I'm not joking.
Oh my God.
It's probably just stupid ass pictures. But,
Of dogs.
Of dogs, yeah, pretty much. Oh, Jenny. All right, so, anyways, me and Jenny actually did something really fun in Downtown Disney. Well, not fun, it was sad now. I slid into DMs, remember? And you helped me? I got liquid courage to slide into my old crush's DMs. I mean, it didn't go as planned. I didn't look at it until I got back on Wednesday.
I kept asking him every day, T, did she write back? T, did she write back?
Yeah, not she never wrote back.
I don't know. I don't check.
I didn't want to jinx it, and then I finally opened it, and it just said scene, and it was pretty funny.
You were left on red.
Even, I know, right? She just, and the fact that I opened up with hey shorty, I thought that was a fucking, who does that? No one. I mean, maybe if we're from different part of the U.S., but still, I thought it was going to work. I thought I was going to.
I had faith in you, too.
Me too. Not her. I felt like.
Apparently.
Yeah, she just not. She just saw and was like, nah, this is like 3 years ago. And she unfollowed me. Well, prior to me messaging her, she wasn't following
okay,
me.
Okay, I thought.
Imagine right after I sent it.
I thought, yeah, she's all blocked.
Either way, and I sent it to her best friend too, and she's like, do it, looks good. She set me up for failure. That's fucked up.
100%.
Yeah,
I don't know who this person is, so I couldn't say.
I was about to say her name, but then they could guess who it is. Oh. Well, she only has two best friends, so it's one or the other. So I won't say the name, but you know who you are. I doubt you watch this, but still, you know who you are.
She's all heartbroken.
But yeah, now I'm going to go to lunch with my other friend that I almost stood up for 35 minutes since she said she's down to go again. I got to get my ego back up to where I was at, even though you got it up earlier today. Yeah. So
I had good news and bad news for you.
Yeah,
good news was better.
It's pointless. It's pointless knowledge to have that. I mean, it was good news because obviously.
Yeah. Well, it's your mother-in-law's birthday next weekend too.
I know. I can't wait. I'm gonna be so drunk. Did you I didn't show you the videos I sent her.
Did you find your shirt yet? You need a shirt.
For what?
It's a theme party.
It's a theme party?
Yeah.
What?
It's Hawaiian theme.
Oh, I got a ton of those. I'm gonna go with the fucking no shirt underneath too, like I did at camping. Flip flops and all. Fuck it.
Look, with your floaties.
Where is it? I thought I just sent it to her. Hold on, let me find it. Maybe not. I don't know where it's at. Either way, it's like, I'm fucked up. I just finished half the bottle. She was all screaming. I was like, oh, this is going to be me at your house. Even though I don't have a DD.
Yeah, me.
Oh, that's
We're
right.
We're going to stay there. Mm. We got to come back the next day.
Okay, drunk me, oh God. No, I had to figure out. I'm gonna have to change over. I know, that's what I was gonna tell her. Nah, I'm gonna have to change over there though, because I'm gonna be all fucking dressed up like I am today. Okay. Two weddings. I never get to invite any dates though. That's what fucking pissed me off. Clearly, they always tell me no, you can't invite no hood rats. I'm like, man.
But Jenny's not really a hood rat. Yeah, I know. She's my manager.
Yeah. Jenny might just take on
his daughter. Yeah.
Jenny just might attack the groomsmen. What's the big deal? Just kidding. No, but this is gonna be this wedding's gonna be fun. It's one of my longest. Not my longest. One of my close. No. Just keep on changing it.
I know. Actually, what
one of my high school best friends, and I was fucking, and then I was fucking with her the other day. She's like, "Yeah, you can't bring no." I was like, "God damn it! I wanted to bring my boy Adrian." No. And she's like, "Oh my god, that's who her ex was, who was madly in love with her and everything." And I was just tease her, and so
that's pretty funny.
But imagine I'd be there, speak now or forever, hold your peace, and this fool would just stand up.
All causing a scene.
I know. I'm like, dude, shut the fuck up. We're in church. Duh, that's where we're supposed to do it at.
Is this the point where I'm supposed to stand up?
Yeah. Adrian, you're too short, bro. They're not going to see you no matter what.
Get on the pew. You can go on my shoulders.
Yell it out. Yeah, say it with your chest. No, I did tell my friend Celeste, because her wedding's next week. And I was like, yeah, Celeste, I can't wait to get drunk at your wedding and speak now, forever hold my peace for Robert. I will fucking kill you. Like, if I ever get killed by one of my friends, she should be the first suspect. The second one's 22-year-old. Cause,
oh, yeah.
Yeah.
She's going to be my first suspect.
Yeah. Yeah. I always tell her she's going to get a job closer to Santa Cruz just so they can take her to Santa Cruz County Jail quicker.
But the crime has to occur over there.
It's
gonna occur here in Hollister.
Oh, shit.
And then your boy can go get you out, get her. And your boy's going to show up and hook her and take her to jail.
Oh, fuck it.
Swinging her in the car.
Oh, shit. Dude, the video that we have of her in your car seat was fucking hilarious. By the way, 22-year-old is technically a midget. She is 4'8", and No, when we went, this was Thursday when we went drinking.
Oh, that's right. But then didn't you guys end up taking your own car?
Yeah, but we drove to her car.
I'm confused. Oh, yeah, because my car was here at the shop.
And then you went to go drop off your car and to go with homeboy. And then we both met up at that random stranger's house. And I went in first before you guys were there.
Oh, yeah. Because you're like, is this the house?
Yeah. And then 22-year-old was like, I got to pee. I was like, I don't know who this. I don't care. I got to go pee. Go knock. I was like, hey, we're with blank. Oh, yeah. Come in. He said you guys are coming. I was like, okay. Hella weird. And then I was like, hey, this house is for sale.
I know. I was like, damn, this is a nice house.
I know. Go buy it after yours sells. But he's selling it for the same reason, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. The worst is really fucking everyone out of a house right now.
For real.
Either way, don't worry. We're trying to get you a nice apartment, or not condo, sorry, yeah, in Ridgemark. Perfect. Homeboy better evict his current tenant. You could play Pogs whenever you want. She said you could come play Pogs.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Yeah, not Thursdays.
We're going to have a Pog tournament.
Oh, God. Pog. Wait, so... Pog tournament. Speaking about tournaments, what happened? PD, the new fucking section. I've seen it on Instagram. You didn't walk in, or how does it work?
On that side. No.
Why not?
I didn't.
You just said fuck it.
I just sat in our regular spot. Well, not outside. Our regular spot's outside, but we sat inside.
I know, it looks fun. I mean, it looks like a nerd heaven.
Somebody said that the games weren't that cool. I forgot who it was. Somebody said it.
They're probably younger cats.
It's your crew.
My crew wasn't there. Who? Davi? Louis?
No. Oh, and
Frankie?
Jeanette starting a tennis club.
Yeah, I know. She told me.
She invited everybody.
I know.
PD that she ran into. Even the fucking dog. She invited the dog. I don't know how the dogs would play tennis, but, you know.
What the fucking... Dogs can ride skateboards. They can play tennis. No, yeah. She told me. I was like, I'll be there for cheerleading.
I'm like, you said beer? I'll be there for beer.
Yeah, exactly. I was like, I mean, and I could literally get fucked up on Wednesdays and just walk home because that dumb park.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a long ass walk, but it's longer than it's not as long as Disney.
Anyone that wants to join us, Wednesdays, 6:30, Dunn Park.
Yeah, Dunn Park to play
bring
tennis.
Bring your own beer. Bring your own tennis racket.
Yeah.
Bring your A game. Fucking...
Wait, why does she want to play tennis? And then there's a tournament in October, supposedly. I don't... Is it teams? Is it solos? I'm confused on how this is going to work.
No, I think solos, and whoever, like, she's going to rate them based on, like, how good they are, and then those people are going to be entered in the tournament.
Wait, so she gets
and
to decide?
And she's having a, I don't know who's deciding. And then she has a full-on, like, she's going to have, like, an award ceremony at her house. Which she's taking this serious.
Yeah, I mean, it's not really that serious if she gets to choose who goes to the finals. I mean, that's just me. Like, I'm going to pick everyone that's worse than me and be like, yeah, you're good enough. You're good enough.
She's like, I don't even know the rules. I was like, then why, like, who's supposed to judge us then? Like,
yeah.
I don't understand.
Yeah, what are, I just know game point. I don't know. Well, how about we just go get a Wii and we'll go play on that? Make life a lot simpler.
Way safer.
Yeah, exactly.
At my age, I'll probably fucking
until you fucking
something.
Until you launch the remote out of your hand.
Into your TV.
Yeah, I know. Man, Jenny, yeah. See, but you can't do this if you move. If you move in October.
Yeah, I'll be back in the hood.
You'll be back in Watsonville.
Yeah.
Let me just.
I can on some Wednesdays still come back and play.
True. I'll be at my mother-in-law's house. It's all good. I love how we got this joke going and she goes along with it too. It's so fun. Until it becomes true, then I'm going to get my ass chewed out. I'm just kidding. Yeah,
pretty much.
Yeah, I'm scared of her. I'm more scared of my mother-in-law than 22-year-old.
Yeah.
Just because I know mother-in-law could probably take me out.
Oh, 100%.
22-year-old, not the strongest looking person.
The strongest.
But
she's little but mighty, bro.
Yeah, little mighty with a fucking knife, a fucking switchblade.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
She pulled out a switchblade on me at the fucking first day that I met her.
Fucking butterfly knife.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. She's all doing it. Yeah, I'm not crazy. Just all fucking flicking her hand up and down. Yeah, fuck that. I'm actually terrified of her. But yeah. It's gonna be a fun summer. If she goes to my birthday, that's gonna be funny.
Yeah.
My birthday, I have no clue who's going. A lot of people have been dropping out like flies. I hope we don't go to lockdown again.
Ugh.
Where?
All right, me and Jeanette are still going.
I totally forgot Jeanette was going.
Yeah.
Dude, I wonder who's gonna try and get at my mother-in-law that weekend.
Oh yeah, all your friends tried already.
Yeah. Let's see, they go round two. Well, one of the homeboys thinks he still has a shot, but we know he doesn't have a shot. clearly. He's a fucking idiot for thinking of it. To think he still had a shot.
He is your friendie.
Yes. And he's clearly an idiot. Like all six. How many friends I got? Five of them. out of the van crew. Yeah, I don't know. It's going to be a fun trip. Then we have my mother-in-law's birthday gift I got her. Wait, when will this come out? Oh, I can't say it because she might listen to it.
She won't listen to it, but.
Well, we got you. No, I'm just kidding. The one time she listens to it, just fucking. Oh, man, I got to figure that out too. I played with the wrong card.
The game?
Yes. I can't believe I just threw money towards a fucking.
Your favorite team? Can you please wear orange too?
I'm going to wear my black LA hat because I'm not stupid. I'm not trying to die being.
Yeah, you're in San Francisco. Nothing's unhappening.
You're tripping. We are the most hated people in San Francisco at that time.
True.
I mean, when we were at the game, there was some Giants fans sitting in front of us and they were all making buddies with everyone.
With you, actually. With your hat.
I'm gonna wear all white and blue. I'm gonna stick out like a fucking sore little thumb out there.
Oh my god.
And then I'm gonna get a little thing that says we're all Dodger fans and put it right here. Just just wave it up.
And then you're walking downstairs, I'm just gonna kick you.
Look, if I get jumped, I understand you have to throw one or two hits and make it look like you're part of the mob and then break it up.
Oh, he's gonna keep going.
I already said that. I'm gonna see little fucking hands going at me. Just what the fuck?
Like a little T-Rex.
I see a little kid face fucking swinging at me. Fuck no, I'll know it's 22-year-old when I see a fucking knife. Good thing they do metal detectors. I feel a little bit safer in there.
That's true.
Yeah.
I had to tell her she had to leave in the hotel last time we went.
And she was all mad at me.
She's like, oh, okay. I was like, yeah, because they check your shit.
I know. Hey, they're horrible at Universal. We went through security. I don't have all my keys right here. And I had all my fucking They didn't even, well, they took my keys to the x-ray, right? I was like, bro, how do you not, like, question me what's in my fucking little cub? I had all my fucking migraine pills in.
All your drug?
Yeah, but, you know, you just see pills in here. At TSA, I would have got fucked. So now I know. I had to fucking clear this out. Or actually, I don't take my keys traveling. But yeah. Anyways, Jenny.
Making lunch plans.
Right now? Are you going with Selena?
No.
Are you going with King City?
No.
Are you going with...
There's too many to go down the list.
Jeanette's neighbor?
No.
Homie from police department here?
No.
Fuck. You know, I feel bad because they watch this and I'm just starting naming them and they kind of know where they are. I just pretty much said all, like, their descriptiveness for themselves. Is this a new one? Have I met this one?
There's no new ones.
Oh, so this is part of repeat?
No, it's not. It's not anyone.
Oh, boring. It's your fucking coworkers. Were you going to Chavela's?
No.
Anyways, for people that don't know, Jenny's a fucking narc. She works for the police department.
I won't even tell you how Jeanette introduced me yesterday to, like, half of the people that were there. She saw, she works for the DEA. I'm all, I do? That's cool.
Just fucking putting you on blast.
She works for the DEA. I was like.
Oh, she said DEA? DEA.
She kept calling it the DEA.
DEA. You're like, yeah.
Yeah, I hustle people for their drugs.
For reals. Could you, would you change your job the way you're at now? Would you, like, apply for something else?
Maybe.
Or do you like your job because it's so chill? I mean, we go to movies every Friday except for this Friday because we had to record because Austin.
I forgot about that.
Because Austin fucked it all up for us. I had a wedding at 2 o'clock. It's 12.
If I go anywhere else, it'd probably be, like, Apple or, like, Google or something.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, yeah. By the way, Jenny's a fucking nerd. So pretty much if you break your phone, Jenny can fucking turn that bitch back on. Jenny's going to actually help me with my next nerd project, the iPhone to a sidekick. Mm-hmm. You know how to solder.
Yeah,
you know how to solder. I don't know how we're going to do it, though. I'm debating to get the XR or the 12 mini, and then I'll get a sidekick, and then we'll just put the screen where the... Where it swipes.
You have to look at, like, the motherboards and see, like, how you can connect them so that they, like, talk to each other.
Yeah. Yeah, we just need to make sure the keyboard works with the fucking thing.
Yeah.
Fuck, we have to get all the schematics all fucking nerdy.
Nerds.
I know. Anyways, guys, I'm about to spend $1,000 on a phone that's not going to work.
That is probably not going to turn back on.
Yeah. A brand new iPhone. Imagine when I take that in, though, and then we
I was going to say you take it back and you're like, my phone's not working.
No, but yeah, if I get it to work. Yeah, can you put a SIM card in this? What is this? It's an iPhone.
Questions.
Yeah. It's an iPhone. Look.
I just created this.
Yeah. That's going to be fun. And
I want to copyright this.
Fuck it. We could probably make kits for them to bring back. Dude, they brought back a sidekick. Like, broken? How many people would get it? They brought back a fucking razor.
Oh, I know. They did.
That was ugly.
Yeah.
Everyone wants a flip phone. Why not? I had a pink one. Mine broke.
Of course he did.
I had a pink one because, first of all, my mom got a new phone, and obviously my mom's like, here, take this one. I was like, fuck it, thug life. Who's going to steal a pink razor? No one stole a pink razor. But yeah, good times.
See, this is the first Thursday we didn't drink together.
I offered you a fucking beer earlier and you told me fucking no. And first of all, today is Friday.
Oh. No, but we didn't go drinking yesterday.
I know. It's because I had to be better for tomorrow. I'm still sad about it.
All of a sudden.
I was about to...
I don't want to drink. It's like peer pressure.
You fucking... What do you mean? You already had a whole crew lined up ready to go. You fucking had 10 people to drink with. Then you even went to Johnny's without me. But look.
I didn't go to Mad Pursuit.
But look at this. Since I didn't go, you got home at a respectable time of 11 o'clock.
This is true.
If I would have went, we would have got home around 2-ish, 1:30.
Last week was 4-ish.
Yeah, 4-ish. Yeah, it was. Yeah, we were out late. No, you got home at 4-ish. I got home at 2:30.
Yeah.
Because 22-year-old got home at 3. Yeah. And that's like a 30-minute drive from Hollister. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you stayed out.
Yeah.
Wow, then. I don't even know why we went. We should have just went home.
I know. We could have gone to Jack in the Box, like our usual end of night.
Oh, I did go to Jack in the Box, per usual. But yeah, I don't even know why we went. It was
because 22-year-old wanted to eat.
Yeah, and we were gonna go happily to Jack in the Box, and then homeboy was like, "We got carne asada," and that chick didn't even fucking eat till like 2 hours into us being there.
Like, why are we here? Oh yeah, you have carne asada.
Was there parking? Was my dad talking shit?
His whole house was open.
He always says that. All right, Jenny's back from moving her car for blocking the door. For people that know where the studio's at, it's in a very private location. really convenient for us to be alcoholics because, I don't know.
Nearby.
Yeah, I've only slept in here about 4 or 5 times from going downtown. And just like, fuck
now
this.
Now you have a futon, too.
Yeah, no, but it's not that comfortable. I think because I don't have pillows here. I need to get some throw pillows to throw on there. But actually, we don't even use that corner no more. I could pretty much just take everything out.
You need one of those beds that like go into the wall?
Yeah.
And like pop.
No, I was thinking about just stacking like maybe 5 high with the ladder and just... So when we all get faded, we just pull it all out.
That's perfect.
Right? Just I got top. I'm fucking climbing as high as they can.
I won't fucking make it to the top. I know. If I'm that fucked up. I know. If I have to be really fucked up in order to fucking stay here.
Yeah. So
at that point, I'm taking bottom.
Even then, you just call, hey, come pick me up. I've seen it before. Still mad that I called the same person. They didn't answer. And they fucking...
2 minutes later.
2 minutes later, you called. But, you know, I do appreciate Selena. She did answer my phone call. Yeah. And for people that don't know Selena, she does not answer any phone calls past 9 p.m. She is a very cranky lady when it comes to sleep. And she gave me a ride, and I'm very shocked. And we talked in the car for another 2.5 hours about some random ass shit.
Yeah.
I was like, dude, I'm too drunk for this.
Probably still having this conversation.
Dude, you know what I hate is being drunk and someone's trying to talk to you, but you're not trying to talk to them, but you don't want to be rude.
You're falling asleep.
You're like, yeah, yeah, damn, that's crazy.
You say it like 20 times. Yeah, damn, that's crazy. The only thing you keep saying over and over.
I know. How many times you got to tell them to shut up and just leave? I mean, I'm taking these things like they're fucking Tic Tacs. And I haven't coughed, so they're working. And I still have to get through a whole fucking wedding, church.
You better not go. You give everybody COVID.
I don't have COVID. First of all, I still have my antibodies. I got tested yesterday. I have my little cheat sheet. I didn't bring it in here because it's in the car. But yeah. Anyways, guys, what were we talking about before you kind of move your car?
You're trying to figure out who I'm having lunch with.
Oh yeah, your coworkers.
No.
Not Selena?
No. Selena has to go drop off.
My cousin Jeanette?
The child. No.
It's hard when you have a lot of people that I know you hang out with. I don't know. I can't. I'm just gonna forfeit.
Forfeit?
But where are you going out? So I can go stalk you guys like you guys did to me? And be like, Selena, let's go watch. You're lucky. I literally can't do it.
The second and third person.
What? I'm showing up to Johnny's right now, guys.
No, that's not. Oh, I didn't even see. That's wrong.
Oh, different person. Oh, okay.
Hello.
We're recording.
Hello.
My manager is answering phone calls.
Hey.
Well, we're almost done. We have like 15 more minutes.
Is he still dying? Yeah, he is.
I am currently dying.
Cough drops.
By the way, I snorted hella vitamins trying to get better. I chopped them up. I was doing party tricks. It was disgusting. Zinc burns your nose a lot more than I thought it would.
Is Sabrosa open?
What else did I do? I'm trying to over-talk over Jenny.
I'll text you. Okay.
Why didn't you even guess Kayla? What the fuck? You were with her last night.
All right. He says he was trying to guess who I was going to go to lunch with. And he's all, why didn't I guess Kayla?
I named all our boyfriends.
He named off all these other dudes except for you.
I heard her.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
She talks really loud. Or my phone's just that bad.
Yeah, at two.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay, bye.
What'd she say?
She's going to go put eyelashes on the bride, and then she'll be done.
What bride?
For lunch. The bride for that wedding.
Wait, what? She's putting... That's an ex of an ex of an ex. Yes, I said that right.
Celeste, is that the bride's name?
No, Alex.
Oh, she said Celeste. So maybe that's...
Oh, maybe, well, she's going to the wedding, too.
Oh,
oh yeah. Dude, I love going to these weddings because I get to hang out with all the idiots I used to hang out with. And, you know, they just don't invite me no more because they don't like my friends. But still, and then I just go make a scene. I say some stupid shit. I bring up shit, old
so,
shit.
Nothing's new. Nothing changes.
For me?
All the time.
Yeah, yeah. For me, nothing changes. For them, they're just like, oh my God, why are you going to bring that up? Why are you going to bring that? And then me and RJ have a gentleman's bet. We're not going to throw each other under the bus. All right, let me tell you the story that happened to, at our last wedding that me and RJ went to. First of all, we know this girl. She's one of our friends. Obviously, slim pickings, right? Everyone's taken, except for me and RJ. She's not the best fucking people to pick from, but still. Me and RJ, gentleman's bet. You know, we, whatever. And I was like, yeah, go for it, RJ. And then obviously I started getting drunk. I was like, fuck it, I'm going to go for it. Long story short, we started throwing each other on the bus. This motherfucker told her, he's like, you're going to go with T? Might as well be going with someone from the bottom of the barrel. All right, this motherfucker.
That's your friend, T.
Either way, I got him back. I was like, you could go with RJ. I mean, I guess he needs to lose his virginity by 30.
Damn.
Long story short, no one won. Because God looked out for me. We were on the way back. And, you know, I drank a lot. Remember, this is my beginning of veganism. So I didn't eat nothing. And God looked out for me. Knew that I was drunk. She was drunk. No protection. This bitch is fertile. She already has a kid. She would have got knocked up. But thank
you. She could have been a dad right now.
Thank you, God, for letting me throw up on myself on the car ride home.
Oh, my God. That's terrible.
I didn't throw up on myself, but I still threw up, you know. Ugh. So, obviously...
Yeah, you're throwing up all over her.
Yeah, so at the end of the day, no one won, which is fair. I mean,
yeah. So now what's the bet, though?
You know, I mean, I just said gentleman bets again. I was like, gentleman bets again. But I think she's back with her dude. So who knows?
Oh, you're still gonna try to get after the same chick?
No, no. We said gentleman's bet, and then he's like with the same one. I was like, I think she's with the dude, but whoever goes up, all right.
Oh my God.
So, no, yeah, you can't go after the same chick twice. No, not especially at a wedding.
Yeah.
No. Am I wearing the same thing? No. I was wearing burgundy.
Burgundy. Oh, that's when you got picked up.
Yeah, when Selena picked me up. Yeah, yeah. That was the day I threw up and everything. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was that wedding.
I had met you.
November.
And that was the wedding was in November.
Was it November?
I think it was November.
I don't know. Let's just look at my Instagram. Look at the photos.
Or was it December?
Either way. I know, and then she called me today, Danielle, my other good friend. She's like, just giving you a friendly reminder because we all know you, that you forget everything. I was like, oh, yeah. She was like, where are you at? I was like, oh, I'm still in LA. When are you coming back? Maybe Friday, but then I leave to Mexico. You better fucking change your plane ticket. I'm going to fucking go say you're a fucking terrorist so you can't get on that damn plane. You cannot miss Alex's wedding. I was like, I'm kidding. I am going to Mexico. I had to switch the fucking flight for her. And she's like, you really switched? I was like, yeah, well, you gave me a fucking 3-week notice. And I've had this trip planned since fucking March, I think.
April, I
think. April.
Because March we went to Miami.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Miami was fun. But yeah, and then, so they're just worried I'm going to miss it. And I'm like, dude, I'm not going to miss it.
Yeah, it's in my calendar. Jesus.
I did. Count it, homie. There's more than that. Look at it.
I love how T talks shit about me answering my phone, but yeah, he's answered it twice.
Count it again. There's 1,050s, and then there's 1,500. Then there's, and yeah, just look at it. Yes, it is. All right, bye. All right, I know, right? I'm still working technically.
Oh.
Either way.
Yeah, me too. Check the emails.
But Jenny works from home. Me and Jenny both work from home. Technically, I'm in my current office. But technically, the studio is my office. We record out of here, and then I sort of do little work. I hardly work, but yeah. Anyways. So either way, I got to make it to this wedding at 2 o'clock. I haven't been to church since I was baptized.
Bro, you're going to burn. They're going to throw the holy water and you're just going to burn.
I'm going to do fucking 10,000 Hail Marys.
Don't take the body of Christ to you.
I never go out there.
That's a sin.
I never go out there.
You're a sinner.
I sit in the back.
I can't even take it. I mean,
I'm bringing my fucking towels so when it gets hot in that bitch, because obviously I'm going to be sweating. I don't have a hat to hide the sweat. I was going to wear a fedora, but it didn't match. I was like, damn, why don't I have a gray suit? If I had a gray suit, would have matched my fedora. But either way, I hope that this doesn't take long.
You realize church is an hour, right, T?
Fuck. I just don't want to be like... just all trying not to cough. Fuck, I had to take cash too.
What do you need cash for?
Don't they pass down the little barrel?
The little barrel? I love
it. Basket. I got $2. Pay my way to get in.
You're going to need like a whole stack of those. You're just making it rain in the basket. Take your gun. With all the hundreds.
Don't worry. God loves me. Technically, I'm probably the most holiest person in that place other than the priest. I've been to the Vatican, me and the Pope, fist pumped. The current Pope.
That's why it burned down.
The Vatican didn't burn down? Talking about the fucking church in Paris. Which is supposed to go... Right. Yeah, the Vatican hasn't burned down.
Yet.
I didn't go inside the church though.
Did
in the Vatican.
Did you go to the American church? At St. Benedict's.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn, how long ago was that? 10 years?
Six. It'll almost be 6 years ago.
Wait, what was your wedding date? When did you get married?
August 8th.
August 8th?
Yeah,
of
2015.
Damn. Yeah. I was barely wilding out at that time.
And I told him, so the day before we're setting up everything, we got married, our reception was at Piscinas Ranch.
Oh, yeah, nice place.
So we went.
That's where your brother got married at. Your stepbrother. My cousin.
Oh. So we were setting everything up the day before in the barn and everything, and then he comes up to me. He's like, oh, it's like one of my groomsmen just got us a party bus. And I was like, no. And he's like, why? And I'm like, because you're driving with your parents to church, because they stayed there the night before and I stayed at my house with my family the night before.
Yeah.
And I got ready at my house, and then he's like, we got a limo to take us to the church. And he's like, no, he's like, I didn't pay for it. It's like, they already got it for me. And I was like, no, I was like, you don't need a party bus. Like, who's going to go on the party bus? I was like, it's not a party. Like,
yeah,
no,
it's a fucking wedding. We're going to church, homie.
So we get to church. I got there like 15 minutes before maybe or whatever. And I forgot what time, I think it's supposed to start at 2.
Mm-hmm.
So like 20 minutes go by. I'm like, dude, where are they?
I rarely like, notice. Hold on. I rarely notice the whole time in the video. You're like covered up by the mic. Yeah, there we go, Jenny.
Oh, he's just short.
I think you could lift it up a little bit.
So anyway, so 20 minutes go by, and I hear like my bridesmaids just like keep coming in and out of the room. I'm like, what the hell is going on? Like, nobody's telling me what's going on. And then I just see like people take off in the mariachi van. Like the van, right? And I was like, what's going on? I was like, is anybody gonna tell me? The freaking bus
the party bus?
Yeah, the party bus broke down. Like, it was only going like 5 miles an hour. Dude. Like, something happened to it.
Had some heavy people on that, had a heavy load.
And I was like, are you kidding me? So then
had like four BKs.
So then our limo and then the mariachi guys, their van, they had to go pick up everybody because there was a hella people in the fucking bus. And I was like, this is why. So I was so pissed, right?
This is your wedding day.
Yeah. So we finally go, like, we're walking down the aisle and I'm pissed. I'm like motherfucking him. I'm like, this is why I fucking told you not to get a bus. And we're literally like, okay, it's about to start. Hold we're kneeling down.
You're jiggling him out in church.
Oh, wait, it gets better. It gets better. So I'm like, I fucking told you, like, why? Like, I told, this is why, like, we're 20 minutes late. Like, now the priest has to, like, rush through all this stuff. So we're kneeling, and I'm still telling him shit. And he's like, he looks at me, he's like, I have a mic on. And I was like, why did they put a mic on you? Like, I told the videographer I didn't want mics on us. And I was just like, oh my God. So watching our video was like hilarious.
Because you're he's chewing you out and he's all mic'd up.
Yeah, yeah. Then the audio wasn't on there, but like my face reaction, like telling him shit, was like priceless. Like, I was like, after we got it, I was like, oh my God, this is hilarious. Because like literally, and everybody like didn't even know about it, right? So you, then
you had another video, watch when we're walking down then, the aisle.
That priest married my parents, right? And so they obviously walked me down the aisle, and like they sat next to each other. So the yeah. priest is like, oh yeah, like look at her parents are like happily married and blah, blah, blah. I'm all, this is awkward. yeah, so it was pretty funny.
I want to watch that video, just you chewing them out, but it just probably looks all nice and peaceful.
Yeah, I gotta find it. I don't know what happened to it, but
we'll throw it in the bonfire. we'll watch it under the stars, and then we'll throw it in there at the end. So when Jenny's divorce is final, we're gonna have a big old bonfire.
Yeah.
Yes, and I'm invited to her divorce party.
Yeah, you're gonna be Tina that
no, Tiffany.
Oh, you're going with Tiffany.
Yeah, because
okay.
Selena.
Okay.
Yeah. Fuck it. No, I'm gonna coordinate the whole fucking trip. I'm just gonna wear a headset.
Yeah. There's gonna be hell of people going too.
I know. I'm like, yeah, never mind. I can't
organize three party buses.
Yeah, I can't organize these bitches. They're too wild.
my aunt wants to go. She's like, can I come too? I was like, yeah. I'm like, you went out to my bachelorette party.
I'll just hang out with Sally the whole yeah, you know,
for real. My aunt's probably more wild. She'll be with us. But,
yeah, it'll be good times. Your sister and your cousin aren't wild. Really.
No, they're not.
They're, you know, she fucking snapped me. She's like, tell me why when I got home, I hella wanted a Jaeger bomb. I was like, shut the fuck up. No, you didn't.
Dude, she got home and she cracked open a Michelob. I'm like, fuck.
Yeah, she's trying to follow your footsteps. Are you older than her or is she older than you?
I'm older than her.
Oh, she's the little sister?
Yeah.
She's trying to be like a big sister.
And then we ended up going to my brother's house later that day too. And I was trying to hide in the house with my sister-in-law, and my brother comes in. He's all, you want beer? And I was like, no. I walk outside. He already had one for me. I'm like, fuck.
Fuck, we drank a good amount. I think I drank from Thursday, Wednesday, to Wednesday.
It was a whole week.
Yeah, I drank a whole fucking week.
We drank a lot at California Adventure.
Yeah, I know. I'm telling you, I was fucking smashed. When I walked back to the hotel, I was like, when we were walking, and I was totally down to go to Downtown Disney. I said, fuck it, who cares? I'm already at this point.
Thank God my mom took the girls.
I know. We got pretty buzzed at, what's it called? At that,
Downtown Disney.
No. At, that fucking Shell place.
The Shell place?
Ariel.
It's not Ariel's Grotto anymore. It's like the Lamplight or something.
Something
like
at
that.
The pier. I don't know. Something weird, but yeah.
The Grotto Shell. Stupid.
Either way, that's
it
where.
It hasn't been Ariel's Grotto for a while.
I'm really upset they didn't have a lot of vegan options, though.
And
I
got fruit.
That dude didn't want to sell me the fruit memories. Like, well, that's I could see.
Kid options.
The fuck? I'm a kid at heart, bitch. Kid at heart, bitch. I just legally could drink alcohol. And they fucking ID'd me after I got, remember when I had to go get our second round?
Oh, yeah.
And they're like, you have your wallet or you have your ID? I was like, no. And well, then you can't get beer.
It's in my friend's fanny pack.
Yeah, I was like, can I go get it and then you'll serve it? Yeah, that's fine.
So
like,
we went on the Star Wars ride on Tuesday.
Yeah.
And we're walking, you know, through the thing. We have to wait in line. And I tell my sister-in-law, was the line this long when we came? And she's like, no, I don't remember any of this.
We walked right through.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I don't remember any of the stuff, like, because we literally walked right on.
Get to the boarding. Yeah, my mom said they waited like an hour and a half, and she was all mad.
Yeah,
I was like, you had to wait?
We had to wait like an hour, too, to like get on. And then the same thing for the Spider-Man one. Like,
yeah, the Spider-Man one was fucking long.
Yeah.
That was pointless. My wrist still hurts.
My sister was like, my arms hurt.
Anyway, so you're the Spider-Man ride, if you're watching, you have to go like this to knock them out, like get the little spiders. Well, fucking Jenny was fucking going like this, fucking. I was like, I just looked at her, and her daughter was like, Mom, get them. Well, she was shooting white shit at the fucking spider. She was like, da, da, da. That's why she beat my score by 100,000. Exactly.
Yeah. And Jayla beat you too.
Jayla beat me too. I'm so mad at Jayla. Did not want to sit next to me.
Oh, I know.
She was.
Or to share her food with me. She was like, grabbed her tray. She's like, nope.
What?
And her fan too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. She was all mad. Yeah, Jayla, I don't know what's up with Jayla.
The girls had like the perfect setup in their strollers. They had like the little mini fan and like clipped onto their stroller. So we're walking through and
they were living the best life.
Yeah, 100%. And at one point, Tina was like, Jayla, I'll give you $10. Give me your fan.
She just looked at me and just
at Disneyland, we ended up buying the other fans with the misters, yeah. Right? And so my niece had it and my cousin's daughter asked her, mm-hmm. for it, right? And she goes, no, you're gonna waste my battery. I was like, damn.
Honestly though, but your daughter is a bully. Move.
Oh, yeah.
I'm in the middle. She pushed her.
Like, my niece wanted to be in the, but yeah, like it was two of them, but not meaning like be in the middle. She wanted to go to the middle rope to,
yeah,
be closer to Jesse. And my daughter's like, nope. Like, totally, like,
she even said no. And yeah, she pushed her, yeah, she shoulder checked
like,
her.
Put her, she even like put her shoulder into it.
I know, I was like little girl fucking put
so
all the weight
together. I didn't get that video, but my sister took a picture and it was a live one.
Uh-huh. And you could see her.
So yeah, you can see it. She's like, I'm in the middle. But then I saved it as a video. So I'm like, oh my god, this is classic. And then I got the picture of her all sad.
I know, that was funny. It was funny. But yeah, Jayla, at your house with fucking the little angel Arya, they're fucking devils towards me. Separate, they don't look at me, they don't talk to me. Even at your house, remember, she like was trying to sit on your lap when I was sitting next to her. When she, I was like, oh Jayla, I'm gonna take one. She's like, no.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And she gave me like a dirty look, and then she kept on getting closer and closer. Either way, Jayla was mean to me this week and I'm sad I didn't get on Cars with you guys.
Oh dude, that was fun.
You guys waited, or
we ended up waiting an hour. It wasn't 80 minutes, it was an hour.
And we didn't, me and fucking homeboy didn't get on Dumbo. So sad. Me and Hector, it was his first time. We didn't do no classics together. Dumbo, Small World.
Oh, we didn't get on Small World either.
I know. I was pumped for it. I thought we were, but everyone's like, no. I was like, I'm all mad.
It's funny because we were, how were we explaining? Oh, when we were going to go on the Incredicoasters, right? Yeah. We're like, oh yeah, it's this. He goes, we're like, don't give it away. Don't tell him. Like, let him experience it for himself.
Oh yeah.
And then he's like, oh man, I shouldn't have drank that beer.
Oh yeah. I know. This is the first time in forever I experienced Kid Disney in a while. I went to Toontown. I haven't been to Toontown in forever. I got to see Mickey's house.
I haven't
house,
been on that Roger Rabbit one in forever either.
Dude, I got myself dizzy.
And that was the first time I went on that little coaster too.
Really? Mm-hmm. That thing's a lot quicker than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
I was like, what the fuck, kids? Yeah, they'd be scared. But I did get myself dizzy on Roger Rabbit and I looked at yours.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, oh fuck, I spun this shit way too hard. And your mom's like, I couldn't spin it.
Because it kept spinning itself.
Well, yeah, you got to spin.
Grab it and like.
You got to spin the same way.
Yeah, and then it was just, like, yeah. I was like, I don't want to spin. Like, just leave it alone.
You guys were just facing this way the whole time, fucking looking at each other.
Yeah.
I know, that's how I got. And then I just started looking at your brother-in-law and sister. I just saw, yeah, I'm dizzy. Just all fucking mad.
I think that's the ride Faith didn't like. I don't think she liked that.
Yeah,
one.
She cried.
Yeah.
Yeah, she cried when she got off.
Yeah.
And then Jayla cried on Star Wars because she thought she was going to get eaten.
I know. That was pretty creepy. I mean, she's literally right in front of it.
And on the 3D was like,
yeah.
I saw like, hey, when we took in the hyperspace, you just gave her like, yeah. She got her ass thrown back.
Well, when we're on the Star Wars ride,
yeah,
right? You know how it drops?
Yeah.
I kind of forgot at what point because we went on it after Downtown Disney, right?
Yeah,
I went on it and I was like, fuck, I know there's a drop, but where, when is the drop, right? Because I wanted to like hold on to her.
Yeah.
But like I did the whole explanation, like it's fake because it's pretty loud in there, like on all the stormtroopers and they all like, they're standing there, right?
Were we just buzzing, not caring?
Yeah. Because
I don't remember it being loud. I just remember saying we should have signed a waiver so they could just like toss us.
Yeah, and I was like, it's fake. It's just a ride. Like, you know, the stormtroopers aren't going to get you. Like, we have to hide, okay? We have to run from them. And she was like, okay. So she was like all excited. And I was like, okay, hurry, hurry. We have to get in the car now. Hurry, we have to hide. We're running from them. She's like, okay. So she gets in. We all get in. And then the girl next to us, She's like, oh, you might want to hold on to her. I'm like, oh, this is a drop. So, like, I held on to her and her face was like, and then I'm like, oh, shit. I don't know if she's going to like it. So then once the ride was over, I'm like, we made it. And she's all clapping. And then she's all, that was so much fun. I was like, all right. She liked it. So then I was like, damn, I should have gone on the Guardians of the Galaxy with her.
I know. Yeah. No, that's a way different drop, though. That one, she would have been like, ah. She would have been floating. No, my mom was all mad because they got on it. She's like, I was so mad. I thought that was it, because you know how you get on the first.
Oh, dude, my mom too. That's what she thought on the spaceship, right?
Yeah, yeah. When you're getting transported.
Yeah. She's like, she walked over to us because, you know, you get to hold on or whatever. And she was like on the other side. She walks over. She's like, don't tell me that was it. And we're like, yeah, it's fun, huh? She's like, you're kidding. And I was like, no, there's more to it.
I know. My mom's like, they need a better way. That should be pointless.
There was too much time in between from that until we got on the thing. So, but when we went on it, it was like boom, 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 boom. Like, yeah, we were on it. We're like, holy shit, what's going on right now?
Yeah, I know. That was like that. I wonder why
we were just buzzed.
Yeah, maybe we did wait in line. I don't remember. We were kind of just out there.
Yeah.
Because we were pretty faded.
Yeah, well, I had to drink everybody's Jaeger bombs.
I drank one of the ones.
I drank my cousin's.
And I drank your sister's.
Yeah.
Hector drank his. I'm proud of him. We could drink again.
I'm telling you, when he gets on whiskey.
I wanted him to go to the cigar lounge with me. Yeah. I'm going to kidnap him, take him to Monterey one day, see if he'll go. I'm like, hey, Lizzie, is Hector home? Yeah, why? Well, I'm going to go fix your mom's thermostat, and then we're going to go somewhere.
Beer meal.
No, but I want to go smoke a cigar with them. Nah, beer meal, we can't get that drunk. I mean, it's possible, but just take fucking
Jalisco's.
Oh, God. I haven't gone out with you in Watsonville other than the one time you picked me up for charging my car.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, I'm scared.
I'm scared.
Yeah, but it's Watsonville. People that don't know where Watsonville at, it's, like, more ghetto than Salinas.
No, it's not. It's not bad.
She has a strawberry tattoo.
Yeah, because my family owns strawberry fields.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, but still gangbanger. But all right, Jenny, we're going to close out there. It was fun, guys. Let me know if you guys rather have Jenny here than fucking Austin.
I even took over.
Yeah. She was
official.
Yeah, she's going to leave the jacket here from now on. But we'll see you guys next week, and I'm going to confront Austin, and we'll make fun of him then. Oh, and then actually, Thursday, when this comes out, we're going to go all watch Austin at PD together.
Yeah.
We'll all be there. We'll have our own little table. You can meet everyone that we talk about, mother-in-law, maybe 22-year-old come out. 23-year-old probably be there. Yeah. And Jeanette will be there. Oh, God. Just kidding. Either way, it'll be fun, guys. I'll see you soon.